This is the former residence of Song Qing Ling, also known as Prince Chun's Mansion, aka. Essentially says what it did in my last video. She turned down living here for a while, and then I think Joe Anlay oversaw the retrofit of the mansion into residence for her. Song Qing Ling moved into this residence in 1963, lived and worked here till her death in 1981. Let's see. So you have a nice little walk around, and then there's an exhibition of Song Qing Ling's life. Long and grapevine, phoenix-shaped scholar tree. So we'll take a walk around the complex. Song Qing Ling. I visited her place, and she's got a mausoleum, and she's got a former residence in Shanghai. And they both have exhibits on her life. This is probably pretty much the same thing as there. For its elegance and splendor, peony is known as the king of flowers. More than 400 Liu Yang peonies are planted here. Among them are 8 famous species: pea green, sea yellow, Joe's pink, lotus sea pod, black gold, snowy white pagoda, and 7 series of color: red, yellow, white, green, black, etc. The peonies were donated by Rui Bo Office Furniture Company Limited, blah blah blah. Not in season for peonies. I saw some peonies at a temple in Yuna Park, Tokyo, in May. I think they bloom in early summer. Let's see. Fan-shaped pavilion. This is an original structure of the mansion of Prince Chun of the Qing Dynasty. It's so named because it's shaped like an open folding fan. The Chinese character, something there, is an ancient form of fan. I guess it's the character for fan. The name is, name sign is in the handwriting of Yi Zhuan, Prince Chun, Emperor Guangxu's father. And it is hot out. I was just thinking when I started walking this morning how I should have come to Beijing a little later in the season when it wasn't so hot. There are plenty of places I could have gone in Northern Europe now, or Central Europe, where it's shoulder season because kids are going back to school. But still nice weather, not too cold. Poor planning. I don't know, the drum tower and bell tower would be close for renovation. They closed it from June to October. So I would think basically the whole tourist season. They did that when I was in Phoenix Park in Dublin. They had their visitor center, which is all the way at the far end of the park, closed for June, July, into August. I finally did get to see it because I went back there in August. And it looked exactly the same as it did when I stuck my head into it when it was closed. The exhibit hall, and I thought, what were they even doing to it that they closed it during the main tourist season? But it looks like they're doing a big retrofit on the drum tower. They had jackhammers going and everything. Pavilion of Grace Giving Water. This pavilion stands on the former site of the Pavilion of Clear Water, In the yard of Clearwater, garden of the mansion of Ming Zhu, Grand Secretary, in the period of Emperor Kangxi, the mansion was reconstructed during the reign of Emperor Jai Qing and became the residence of Prince Cheng. As the water was diverted into the garden from the imperial waterway, the emperor's special permission, the pavilion, with the emperor's special permission, the pavilion was named Pavilion of Grace Giving Water to express gratitude for the favor. Are we allowed to peek in the windows? The roses are hanging on here. The roses that we know today in most gardens, there's so many varieties, but they're usually a cross between European and Chinese. If you go back to the original breeds of roses that were bred for ornamental flowers. When I was in Dublin at the Botanical Gardens, they had a small rose garden. They talked about the original roses bloomed only for a couple days and dropped their blossom quite rapidly. And then there was a cross with the Chinese version. They stayed they started making huge varieties that stayed in bloom or had multiple blooms. The exhibition room, Chinese flowering crab apple. Hello. Song Ching Ling's. Song Ching Ling liked to play Karamom. She often played it with her staff members in her spare time. 挺好的，我觉得你再工作几年，对。现在呢？ In this small dining room, Song Qingling entertained many of her guests. Song Qingling took her meals here. She also entertained guests from China and abroad on many occasions. Pantry of small dining room. She was a very big promoter of children. not promoter, but benefactor of like orphanages and things like that. Song Qingling was actually, I think she was related to, or no, her sister married Chiang Kai-shek's Minister of Finance. The place Song Qingling treated guests from both China and abroad. October 12, 1979, big dining room. She treated Cambodian Prince Sihanouk and his wife here. June 14, 1963, at the reception held in celebration of 25th anniversary of the establishment of the China Welfare Institution, originally the China Defense League. Zhou Enlai warmly claimed the birth of the institute and proposed a toast to the health of Song Qingling. That was her thing. China Welfare Institute. I think it was for children mainly. Here's the crab apple tree, midget crab apple trees. These old trees are planted in the mansion of Prince Chun during Qing Dynasty. When they bloom around April 10th every year, they are an attraction for enjoying flowers in the capital. Song Qingling made crab apple jam with the fruit of these trees. Place Song Qingling received guests from both China and abroad. November 6, 1964, she met the Soviet China Friendship Association. Peng Shen, Lu Ding Yi, Gu Moreau, Huang Yanpai, Chen Shutong, Cheng Qian, Lin Feng accompanied the meeting. Yeah, it's too hot here in Beijing. I should have come here in another month or two. Way too hot. Return by the way you came. Hard to enjoy things when it's oppressively hot. Unless that's like the best time of year. I was in Bangkok in November and it was still oppressively hot, but that's about as good as it gets. So you deal with it. That's the bathroom. Yeah, I think it's her sister who married Chiang Kai-shek's finance minister, then another sister was married to someone famous. There's a saying about them. One married for love, one married for money, one married for power, I think. Song Qingling, of course, is she was the wife of the father there at China. Zhongshan. Bedroom also used as office during the years of her life, age 70 to 88. Song Qingling spent most of her time living and working here. She led a thrifty and simple life. It's as shown evidently by the outdated furnishing in the room. Despite her advanced age, she worked tirelessly all day long. It was here at 8:18 p.m. May 29th, 1981, that she died of illness after all rescuing measures proved ineffectual. Her working condition was simple. The lampshade of the floor lamp by her desk was made out of an old curtain by herself. She often worked late into the night. The Strauss brand upright piano by the north wall was a gift from her first younger brother, Sung Shi-won. She often played at leisure to enjoy herself. By the west wall of the study room, there is an old radio, a gift to Sung Ching-ling in the 1950s from the government of the Soviet Union. Is this her dying? Conferred on her the title Honorary Chairman of the People's Republic of China, May 16th, 1981. Specially urgent document in hand. Liao Chengji is the guy there who's visiting her. Close to the east wall, there sits an old-fashioned English typewriter which Sung Ching-ling used to write letters or to do other writings almost every day. On his visit to China, the Japanese-American friend Koji Iriyoshi brought to Sung Ching-ling a bouquet of Hawaiian flowers called Antharium, which symbolized auspiciousness and wish fulfillment. She liked the flowers very much, hoping to keep them as fresh as ever. She made an embroidery of the flowers with the help of her attendant and put it up on the wall near her bed. She was married in Japan, actually, to her husband when he was over there to study the industrialization that Japan had gone through. In the bookcases by north wall of the study was kept part of her library in Beijing, numbering some 1,600 books and more than 1,100 copies of magazines. The photocopy of an inscription written by Sun Yat-sen, that's her husband, in Mandarin, he's Zhongshan, is his name. That's why you see parks everywhere, right? Zhongshan Park. For the Peiyuan Middle School in Chuanzhou, Fujian Province, kept on the glass on her bedside table. It reads, to advance together to the world of great harmony, which was the objective of Sun Yat-sen and Sung Ching-ling, a lifelong struggle. Whenever going to Shanghai for a short stay, Sung Ching-ling always brought it along and put it on the bedside table there and took it back with her on her return to Beijing. She was an ardent lover of reading books. She was well-grounded in English language and had a good knowledge of French, German, Russian as well. There was in her library quite a collection of books in foreign languages. Most of her letters and many important writings were done in English. Her dad worked as a businessman, I think, in the United States for a period of time. And she went to college at, was it Wesleyan that she went to school? She wasn't a Vassar girl, but I think she went to Wesleyan. It smells like my grandma's house in here. It's mothballed. Looks like it too. Grandma Jo, where are you? Are you in here? Bedroom also used as office during the last 18 years of her life, age 70 to 88. Sung Ching-ling spent most of her time living and working here. She led a thrifty, simple life. This is the same thing we already read. The Sun Yat-sen Museum I went to in Hong Kong was rather informative. It's the first place I learned about him, really. Never really got to be president of China because a warlord forced him out after the liberation. Well, the revolution, 1911. All the cooking utensils here were used by Sung Ching-ling. Sometimes she cooked for her friends at this kitchen. Now, I thought her mausoleum was in Shanghai, because I went to Sung Ching-ling's mausoleum in Shanghai, so I thought that's where she was buried. So I thought she died in Shanghai. Well, 1975, she won all her books in Beijing and Shanghai homes, given to Dang Guangyin, son of her old friend Dang Wenzhou. After Song Qingling passed away, Dang donated all the books to former residents of Song Qingling. There they are together. Sun Yat-sen really never got to see his plan for the industrialization of China to be implemented either. He wrote treaties. Hello. On port development, railroads, commerce. He'd probably be happy with what's going on now, I think. There's a wheelchair. Dove coat. Song Qingling was fond of keeping doves, symbol of peace. Also memory to Sun Yat-sen, who liked doves too. They had some doves at Sun Yat-sen's former residence in the French Quarter in Shanghai. Dove coat are an old way that the aristocrats in Europe used to have fresh meat during the winter. The doves would fly out from the dove coat and eat the grain of all the farmers. So they were pretty easy to take care of. And then you just had to go to the dove coat and get the eggs and kill a few pigeons for fresh meat. I think in Europe you used to have a special license from the king to have a dove coat because of it. October 2001, Mr. Lin Yun Ta, born in Miaoli, Taiwan, president of Winter International Pigeon Supply. Blah, blah, blah. Residence late Song Qingling. Very impressed to learn of her great, glorious life and felt a great respect and esteem for her. Excited to learn that Song Qingling had a great love for pigeons. They decided to donate 12 pairs of breeders with internationally known bloodlines to her peace loft. Coo, coo, coo. Rats with wings is what I call them. You and me and the devil makes three. Won't you be my Evelyn, babe? Oh, 1116. Exhibition of her life. Let's see where we are now. We're over here at 7, huh? So she's a good role model for Chinese kids. She lived a simple but purposeful life. Willy Wang.
Responsibility of the CSCLF to inherit and publicize, assume spirit of devotion, and carry forward her unfulfilled work. Being benefit to safeguarding world peace, promoting reunification of the country, working hard for future generations. Non-governmental organization, institute, public welfare, etc., etc. Former president of Republic of Tanzania, Julius Nyerere. Huku Waterfall, Yellow River. International visiting programs.
Hey, cool. She had a old limo. Hu Yao Bang presided over the memorial meeting. Zhang Zemin, ceaseless fight, hard work, country and people, mankind's progress. Deng Xiaoping exerted herself to the utmost for 70 years, as if it were a day, to devote the energies of a lifetime to Chinese people's democratic and socialist cause and cause of the world peace and progress of mankind. Seahorses. Letters and medicine sent by people from various parts of the country during her last days. Huh. People sent her seahorses, huh? Get better! Medical personnel are doing everything to rescue Sung Qingling. People are old, let them die. That's what you gotta do. Don't play God. Everybody dies. University of Victoria, honorary doctor of law. Canada's university. Gem of our nation. Won the love and esteem of her people across the country. Passed away at her Beijing residence. Zez sedan made in Soviet Union. Gift from Joe Stalin, huh? Interesting. Soviet vehicle. I won't go into too much detail because you can watch my video of her. Museum, two museums in Shanghai. Work for children cannot wait. Educate children morally, intellectually, physically, aesthetically. Great undertaking for the future. Hundred years of war. Nice outfit. Embroidered wedding gown of her mom. Sung Qingling's Japanese-born American friend Koji Ariyoshi, who used to support China's war resistance against Japan, had been arrested under Smith Act in the USA. Hearing the news, Sung Qingling sent the gown to Hiroshi's family, suggesting they could sell it to finance Ariyoshi's defense. They didn't want to sell it and kept it with care. Return to China by Roger Hiroshi. Ariyoshi.
globe given to China reconstructs by Sung Qinglin. There she is with Zhou Enlai and Gu Moru. Sign their names to the Stockholm Appeal for World Peace. Envoy for World Peace. Member Executive Bureau, World Peace Council. President Liaison Committee. Peace Conference of Asian and Pacific Regions. China Reconstructs, Now China Today. Founded by Sung Qinglin, important medium. Informing people over the world about facts of socialist China. Some art from Africa, it looks like. Wood carved statuette, presents from Indonesian friends. Pakistan, small silver boat. Silverware, Burmese government, 1956. So not African. Textile Research Institute, Burma. Indian Premier Jawaharlal Nehru. Pakistan Premier Karachi. Karachi, golden key to the and citizenship of the city. Colombo, capital of Ceylon, which is Sri Lanka. Chinese Ambassador Huang Chen, Indonesian President Sukarno. Signing of the Declaration of Communist Parties and Workers' Parties Socialist Countries by Mao Zedong. Woolen suit worn by Sung Qinglin when she went to Moscow in 1957. Celebration of the 40th anniversary of the October Revolution. Distinguished leader of state. September 1949. First plenary session of Chinese People's Political Consultative Conference. Elected vice chairman. Central People's Government. People's Republic of China. Speech, comrades, let us proceed with our task of building an independent, democratic, peaceful, strong, and prosperous new China, and together with the peoples of the world bring about everlasting peace. At the sessions of the Chinese People's Political Consultative Conferences and the National People's Congresses in succeeding years, she is re-elected Vice Chairman of the People's Republic of China, Vice Chairman of the Chinese People's Political Consultative Conference, and Vice Chairman of the Standing Committee of National People's Congress. As one of the major state leaders, Sung Qinglin took part in many activities, both national and international, for more than 30 years, making outstanding contributions to her country in socialist revolution and construction. Mounting the Tiananmen rostrum. On the road to industrialization. Grand ceremony, founding of the People's Republic of China, 1949. Party and state leaders stepped into Tiananmen rostrum. Mao Zedong, Zhou Di, Sung Qinglin. Mao Zedong, Zhu Di, Zhou Enlai, Los Angeles Nursery. China Welfare Fund. ...1945, greeting the Donut Victory.
After the victory over the Japanese aggression, Sung Qingling reorganized China Defense League into the China Welfare Fund, ready to participate in building a peaceful China, but the Kuomintang regime, adhering to its dictatorship, started the civil war. Peace was destroyed. Sung Qingling solicited for a large quantity of medical supplies and tried every possible way to transport them to the liberated areas under communist control, giving great help to the Chinese people in their fight for liberation. She also appealed for international as well as domestic aid for social relief. In Shanghai, she set up 3 children's welfare centers and a children's theater to help the poor people, particularly the poor children, to tide over their most difficult times. I think I'm walking through this exhibit backwards. I guess maybe there's another entrance to the building at the other end. Kind of frustrating. It says to go through this way, though. It's weird they have you walk through backwards this time. Where are all these folks? Edgar Snow. Shaanxi Province, Red Star over China. They had an exhibit about some of these writers at the archives in Shanghai. And he dedicated his book to her, I think, telling the world objectively about the Communist Party. Israel Epstein, American journalist writer. Agnes Smedley, American woman writer, journalist. With Sung Qingling, she assisted in setting up the China League for Protection of Civil Rights during the anti-Japanese war, headed for Yan'an, and did rescuing and nursing work in the battlefield of Shaanxi. Indian Rescue Corps, 5 doctors. James Bettram, New Zealand journalist writer, came to China in 1936, participated in publicity work of the CDL, and took many times responsibility to deliver relief goods to anti-Japanese bases. Sung Qingling, Talitha Gerlach, American Friend member, CDL. Let's see, received warm responses from people in all walks of life. China Welfare Appeal. Including Miss Eleanor Roosevelt and the President's mother. Hans Müller, German doctor, Yan'an. Ma Haid, Dr. George Haydom, American doctor, Yan'an. General Advisor of Health Department, Central Military Committee, CPC. Founding members of Medical and Health Work in New China. Rui Ali, New Zealand writer and poet. With Edgar Snow, initiated China Industrial Cooperation Campaign 1938. Shandong, Gongsu Province. Sung Qingling helped arrange a large group of internationalist fighters to join China's anti-Japanese war, especially in the bases of 8th Rao Army and New 4th Army. They fought bravely and some even sacrificed their lives, contributing greatly to the cause of the Chinese people's liberation. Sung Qingling left for Chongqing, last flight from Hong Kong, 6 hours before Hong Kong was occupied by the Japanese. This was taken Chongqing, 1942, where she continued with CDL work. Chiang Kai-shek's mansion, Chongqing. There's Sung Qingling, Chiang Kai-shek, and Sung Ailing and Sung Miling. Those are her sisters. Yeah, there she is with her sisters. Los Angeles Nursery. Yan'an, donations from overseas Chinese and other people in LA. Chinatown, I guess. LA, a lot of donations for money. Offering gifts to anti-Japanese officers and soldiers in Chongqing. Catastrophic flood hit Henan Province when Yellow River Dike broke, 1943. Sung Qingling organized benefit soccer matches in Chongqing to provide relief. Yeah, There she is with her sisters. Song. Sung. Well, that's their family name, I guess, is Song. So Qingling, Meiling, and Ailing are the three sisters. Cheongsam, or Qipao in Putonghua. Cantonese is Cheongsam. Chinese style gown presented by Sung Qingling to Polly Babcock, who wore it overseas to collect donations for Gung Ho movement in China. Banner presented to Sung Qingling by patriotic overseas Chinese Philippines during war resistance against Japanese aggression. Chinese style gown worn by Sung Qingling during period of CDL. The world of Susie Wong introduced me to Cheongsam. The old William Holden movie set in Hong Kong starts off on the Star Ferry. The Bowl of Rice campaign is not only a fun collection, but an emblem of sacrifice. This virtuous form of conduct has always been worth praising both in China and abroad. In ancient times and today, the Bowl of Rice campaign in Hong Kong has even more profound meaning. It is to help the Chinese industrialist cooperatives to reorganize the refugees and wounded, for strengthening the economy, for production to save the country and help the people to help themselves. This is the most effective form of relief. Donations handed over to Gung Ho as relief for wounded soldiers, refugees. These bowls were used in the campaign. Bowl of Rice campaign. Qilai. Paul Robeson, songs for anti-Japanese, such as March of the Volunteers in Chinese. Huh. Paul Robeson, world famous black singer. China's greatest strength lies in awakening her masses. With China's immensely vast territory, rich in natural resources, with a population of 400 million people. Can't be right. 400 million, yeah. Back then. The might of Japan becomes a mere paper tiger. Japanese economic and social structures cannot hold out long. A long war with the Chinese people. No, China could not be defeated, even if she had to fight Japan single-handed, and China will not be alone, for China has the sympathy of the world. China unconquerable. It's true, the Japanese overstretched themselves with their East Asian co-prosperity sphere. Saved China in the face of jail terms. Kuomintang authorities secretly arrest 7 leaders of the All-China Federation of National Salvation Associations. Oh yeah, I went to the area where they killed them. Suzhou High Court requesting they be freed, yeah. She stuck up for them. Because of her ties to Chiang Kai-shek, she was sort of beyond reproach. Her family ties. Where is that area in Shanghai where I went to the area where the meeting between of those folks who ended up getting executed by the KMT? It's kind of in that area where they have the Culture Street and the art museum that they turned into a kids' art museum. They closed it. It was a modern art, contemporary art museum. They closed it as soon as it opened and turned it into a kids' art museum. Where is that? It's in the north section. Shaibei, maybe. Hongkou. We are ready to go to prison. We are willing to go to prison for national salvation. We believe this is our glory and our responsibility. We're all Chinese. We all want to save China from destruction. 7 leaders of the National Salvation Association
have been arrested, but there are still 400 million people whose patriotic wrath and righteous indignation cannot be suppressed. Let the Japanese militarists beware, and they may cause the arrest of seven leaders, but there are 400 million people here in the whole of China. And maybe it's a different group of people than this is referring to. They're arrested by the Japanese. Save China and face a jail. Well, they mentioned Shanghai. Shanghai Press. Kuomintang government. That's the government, the Republican nationalist government of Chiang Kai-shek. X-ray machine donated by overseas Chinese in Singapore. Through the help of General Stilwell, machine was taken to Yan'an by an American army plane. Dr. Hans Mueller shown treating a patient. International Yan'an International Peace Hospital. Meeting with Joseph Stilwell, General Joseph W. Stilwell in Chongqing. General Stilwell. It's kind of the forgotten theater, the Burma theater, flying over the hump to help supply the Chinese. Chenault's flying tigers and all that. Every time we learn about your opinion and activities for the revolution and national salvation from newspapers and the mouths of comrades from other places, it inspired our unlimited esteem. Sun Yat-sen, Spirit of Revolution, National Salvation. George Bernard Shaw came to visit, huh? I was at George Bernard Shaw place, birthplace in Dublin. There he is there. I never thought of George Bernard Shaw as Irish. I always thought he was English, but he's actually born in Ireland and left when he was a kid for England. Never really wrote much Irish literature, except I think one play set in Dublin. But he wrote Pygmalion, his famous work, that kind of satirizes British colonial aristocracy policy. Japanese imperialists kept escalating the war of invasion in China. Sung Qingling believed that Chinese people must unite to resist the Japanese aggression, blah blah blah, internal pacification, resistance for an invasion, different forms of struggle, revolutionary patriotic progressive personnel, Japanese aggression. She played a unique role in promoting the cooperation for a second time between the KMT and the Communist Party of China. Founded China Defense League in Hong Kong, advocated gung-ho industrial cooperative movement, which won large amounts of international aid for China's war of resistance. Collected donations, carried out wartime relief in an extensive scale, and organized people to help themselves through production in China. All these activities provided strong support for the protracted war. It's essentially what her husband did. Sun Yat-sen traveled around the world getting a lot of donations for the 1911 revolution to succeed. And he was an outlaw in his own country for most of that time. Cape Horn by Sung Ching Ling, which he stayed in Europe. She is by her typewriter. Sleepless Night. Protesting the Kuomintang's action in violation of Sun Yat-sen's revolutionary principles and policies, and announced her temporary retirement. Declaration of Song Soon Qingling, current situation.
Also, the July 14th declaration.
This was after 1927, when Chiang Kai-shek started to go after communists in Shanghai. Up till that point, there was cooperation, and they didn't merge the parties, but communists were allowed to join the KMT as individuals. And then in an act of perfidy, Chiang Kai-shek makes power grab, and he arms some thugs, and they mow down. What is it, the Green Gang? He arms them with weapons. And they mow down a lot of communists.
No longer Sun Yat-sen's true believers. The party is no longer a revolutionary party, but a tool of one warlord or another. In Wuhan, 1927.
Excuse me, no
yeah.
Flash.
Okay. Carrying on Sun Yat-sen's cause, Sun Qingling faithfully carried on the three major policies introduced by Sun Yat-sen: alliance with Soviet Union, cooperation with Communist Party of China, and assistance to the peasants and workers. Protest. Statement in protest against violation of Sun Yat-sen's revolutionary principles. New Road for Chinese Revolution. Honorary chairperson to conferences, International Anti-Imperialist League, held in Belgium 1927, Germany 1929, respectively. Chief leaders of the World Anti-Fascist Committee. Women of the East and West, unite, change the world. Fur hat kept by Sun Qingling, Sun Yat-sen wore it to protect himself from cold in Tianjin when he came to the north. So when he tried to assume the presidency in 15? Something around there. Is it a robe? Before Sun Yat-sen and Sun Qingling were married, Sun Yat-sen asked someone to buy a clothing material and had a Japanese-style morning gown made to Sun Qingling's measurements by a tailor. This is when they were in Japan, studying the industrialization. You know, when I was in Suzhou, they said that there was a emissary from Japan sent to Suzhou during the period when Suzhou was the capital, and like, I don't know, around 500 AD, and that's why the kimono in Japan is similar to the style of wear that the court of Suzhou at the time had. I never knew about that connection, and I've not read it anywhere since. It's a fascinating connection. Warlord Chen Jiangming staged an armed rebellion in Guangzhou, Shell presidential residence. Sun Yat-sen went on board the Yangfeng to direct suppression of the rebellion. The picture showed warship Yangfeng, later renamed Zhangshan, which is his name in Mandarin, Sun Yat-sen's name. Pistol, Mauser pistol, wedding gift to Sun Qingling from Sun Yat-sen. Gave her a gun. Winter 1919, Sun Yat-sen, Sun Qingling took a photo in Shanghai to celebrate their fourth anniversary of marriage. On the right is Sun Yat-sen's inscription for Sun Qingling, which describes their love, devotion, and comradeship in arms. Shanghai 1920. My wife is a woman educated in an American university and daughter of my earliest collaborator and friend. I've begun to lead a new life. It is a true family life I had never enjoyed in the past. How lucky I am to be able to live with my bosom friend and assistant. Standing by Dr. Sun Yat-sen through thick and thin. August 1913, left United States, Tokyo, Japan. Many Chinese revolutionary members converge. Sun Qingling married Sun Yat-sen 1915 while he was in exile. Became his close companion, ardent supporter of revolutionary career, long hard struggle defending newly born Republic of China. 10 years of their married life, despite revolution, suffering setbacks, difficulties, repeatedly, sometimes cruel struggles, Sun Qingling followed Dr. Sun Yat-sen steadfastly and shared him with him joys and sorrows. November 1924, Sun Yat-sen went north to China to take part in the negotiation for national peace and unity. Unfortunately, he died 1925, Beijing. He's buried in the Purple Mountains near Nanjing, I think, is his mausoleum. They have a model of it at his former residence in Shanghai. They also call the suit that everybody wears, that communist garb, that khaki gray color, a Zhangshan
Sukes, I think it was designed by Sun Yat-sen. Wine brought back from America after graduation. Yeah, Wesleyan College for women in Macon, Georgia. So not the New England school. Three song sisters were studying there. Macon, Georgia. Young Qingling with their mother, Ni Guizhen. Manhattan. Shanghai, the birthplace of Song Qingling. The brocade was treasured by Song Qingling all her life. Oh, it's the Bund.
Yeah. There's the Peace Hotel now and the Bank of China's old building there. Old HSBC building there, right? Which one is this one? I always confuse these two. And there's the hotel there. I think Sun Yat-sen stayed in there at one point. On his honeymoon, maybe.
With her. The hotel at the north end across the Suzhou Creek. The Wusong River, what's the name of that hotel? Dr. Sun Yat-sen, born 1866 in Guangdong province. They changed the name of his county to name it after him. He organized revolutionary organizations, parties, launched uprisings for 10 times, often had failure, defeated time and again, became more courageous, stronger. Revolution succeeded in 1911. He studied medicine first in Guangzhou, then Hong Kong. I don't know if he went back to Guangzhou, Guangdong province anyway, and then he's kind of traveled around the world. They claimed Sun Yat-sen as president, but he lasted only 44 days, forced to resign. The warlord, Yuan Shikai, took over. Reactionary nature soon manifested itself. Sun Yat-sen launched the second revolution, failed again, and he left for Japan in exile in 1913. Revolution was in an extremely difficult situation. Gathering his forces again, Sun Yat-sen reorganized Chinese Revolutionary Party, preparing to launch the third revolution. There he is with some of his classmates, College of Medicine for Chinese. There's a Sun Yat-sen historical trail that I walked. I don't think I took any video, just pictures when I was in Shanghai. And they don't let you take any video at his museum either. But it's a good museum in Shanghai, in Hong Kong. The Sun Yat-sen historical trail too kind of goes around different areas where he had meetings. For the failed uprisings. Brass turquoise hairpin given to Song Qingling by her grandmother. There's the exit. I'm guessing we're looking at a timeline of her life there. So she didn't just live the rest of her life as a footnote to her husband, Song Qingling. She had a active life for decades as a force for not only China, but children around the world, international peace. She, because I think of her command of English and other languages, traveled extensively and acted as a official, unofficial ambassador for the Communist Republic, People's Republic. And go down this little area here. Have some more of her clothes here.
cotton mill inspection. Shanghai. Jiangsu Province, Songjiang. Inspection tour, rural areas. On our left is the national labor model, Chen Yongkang. Some of her stuff here. A trade, a true public servant, visiting factories, place herself among the masses, rural areas, army units, urban neighborhoods, national minority regions many times. Being a true public servant, she was modest and kind, always treating other people as equals. Song Qingling was very strict with herself and always regarded herself as one of the ordinary working people. She always took the interests of the whole into account, made a clear distinction between public and private interests, showed solicitude for other comrades, worked hard and lived simply. Cool. Sounds good. That's her gown from her honorary doctorate. She got a lot of honorary doctorates. There's the gift shop. I'll start a new video, I guess.